Hello everybody. In this video, you will see how you can use the Dexso PTFE foil to improve the quality of your plant-based oils. We will show you how to make a collection vessel from PTFE and how to ensure that no contaminations like dust or water can get into the oil during the extraction procedure. Condensation can be a big problem when the outside air is warm and humid. A can of beer from a fridge of 7 degrees accumulates already quite some drops of water in summer, so you can surely imagine the huge amount of condensation that can occur with dimetal ether that runs out of the extractor at less than minus 25 degrees Celsius. This will lead into water staying behind in your oil. As a result, your oil will not be pure, but an emulsion, a mixture of oil and water. It will deteriorate faster and not be as transparent and hard as it could have been. Dexso PTFE foil is big and extra thick Teflon sheet. It is considered to be 100% resistant to Dexso dimetal ether, but also to butane and ethanol. It can resist to temperatures of over 200 degrees Celsius, and it doesn't stick to the oil when the oil is hard. Here you see me folding the PTFE foil so I get four even squares. These can be used to make four collection vessels, for example. I use this little GoPro box because it has a usable shape. I center it nicely in the middle of such a square and then I fold the sides up and I'll fix them with a paper clip. So this can already serve as a little vessel in which you catch the extraction liquid. If you want to be even more hygienic and avoid the condensation, you will have to make two or actually three of these boxes. So as you can see now, I'm in another box and I cut a hole in the bottom. I made another one without a hole in the bottom. And here's the original one which I made. You can see the first one which I made, it's made with paper clips, while the other ones are stapled. The paper clips are convenient because when you're ready, you can just open up easily the foil and work it or use it any how you want, so it doesn't stick to the oil, so you can easily get the oil out later, and while if you use paper clips here, you might even be able to reuse the same type of PTFE foil. And it's quite thick, a bit thicker than the PTFE that I've seen till now, so it's surely gonna last longer. So, why did I make the hole in this box? It's because if we want to do really shield off the extraction liquid, then it has to be closed off completely. So the end of the extractor should more or less end up in a closed off box. And this is what we're gonna do with this. So the hole is just big enough so the extractor will slide through it, but the lower part, which is larger, will keep it from sliding through, and like this it can hang. So you can slide this over the box we made in the beginning. And as soon as you're ready with your extraction, you have to put down the extractor, of course, because you're not going to stand for half an hour to wait till the solvent is evaporated. So with this one on the side, you can easily put your extractor down when you don't need it, and you take this one just to seal it off. Like this, you protect it for dust. The condensation will form on the outside of the vessel,
so you won't end up with it in the oil. And eventually, as soon as enough solvent is evaporated, you can just take the little vessel and put it in your vacuum room. You can already open up then the plastic if you want to, or just purge it in the little box.
Now you will see how to use the PTFE during purging. Right after the extraction, we have closed off the PTFE box with the oil with a PTFE cap. This closed box we can heat up with warm water of about 30 degrees. Herefore, we put the box in a Pyrex bowl and will make it float in the water. Like this, the DME will be evaporated in about 40 minutes. You can add warm water to maintain the temperature if you need. As soon as most of the solvent has evaporated, we can take the box from the Pyrex bowl, remove the cap and place it in the vacuum chamber. After removing the paper clips, we can open up the foil so the oil has all the room to expand as soon as we create the vacuum. Don't use too high temperatures during the vacuum procedure, because you will lose terpenes who are responsible for the smell and the taste of your oil. Since dimethyl ether evaporates way faster than butane or ethanol, we can also work with relatively low temperatures. Caused by the gravity, the oil will in time start to sink and push the solvent out of the air bubbles. Like this, your oil will get purer and purer. In this particular example, we were using a temperature of 32 degrees Celsius. Eventually you will end up with an oil with a consistency of something in between of a sticky butter or a solid glass-like plate that can shatter into pieces. I hope that this was useful for you. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to be kept updated. And if this was interesting for you, you might want to have a look at our Facebook page too. If you have a suggestion, leave it in the comments, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.